to explain what's going on here. And this is the sin of the smart meter, okay? So the smart meter switch mode powered by circuitry does not have what you have in your laptop power supply, your PC power supply, your TV power supply, your washing machine, whatever electronic device you got, okay? Inside those devices, there is a circuit that allows mitigation of what's called common mode current and differential mode current from backfeeding onto the power line that feeds the switch mode power supply. Okay, so there's a pair of coils. Differential mode is a pair of coils, and common mode is one coil. So there's wires wrapped around that come in from the power line or from the switch mode power supply. It depends on whether it's the AC side or DC side. They have different designs for each one. Yeah. Okay, but basically what it's going to do is those what they call, they're kind of an inductor, but they're a choke coil, basically is what they're called officially. And so it's a spiral wrap. I have a presentation on my website about this whole thing, about the circuit design that could have been put in place that would have saved everybody all this nightmare, okay? And I'm not kidding you. It's a cost of about $2 per meter to fix this. They will never fix it because they want to spend $2. So the reason that everybody put a smart meter on, suddenly you're sick, right? That's how reaction I get from people. Put the smart meter on or the opt-out meter on and I'm suddenly sick. What's going on? So I did some research in this and looked at the design. I've ripped apart every smart meter I get my hands on and look at the circuit board design and stuff like that. And that is the one missing thing. They do not have a choke coil that prevents common mode current and differential mode current from backfeeding onto the power that's feeding the circuit. Mm-hmm. So now this common mode current and differential mode current, even though it's very small, let me explain that. It's not amps, okay? It's in milliamps, okay? And it's backfeeding on all the power lines in the house. So the house becomes this huge, you know, conductive characteristic. And that is what I have found to be the fundamental reason why smart meters are causing people to be sick. The switching mode power supply has transient voltages also. So it's a combination of both. But in my estimation, common mode current to differential mode current in all my other experiments in life before I got into this business, okay, is something to be avoided at all costs. The power supply for your laptop will show you more transients possibly, voltages, but I guarantee you the common mode and differential mode currents are removed because I worked for Hewlett Packard and I worked on power supplies for laptops and for power PCs. And this is one of the things we did to avoid that problem. If you rip apart your switch mode power supply for your laptop, and I have one here somewhere, I don't know where, but you'll see these coils in there. They're physically present. Okay. Now, will it have possibly some transient voltages? Yes. It's possible it will. Okay. Not all of them do, but many do. And so we're all focusing on, you know, plugging in the Spencer meter and the green wave meter and measuring millivolts or measuring GS units and all this kind of stuff. We see a big number or a larger number, which can be mitigated. But the common mode current, if you don't catch it at the circuit, you'll never be able to mitigate it.
Yeah, it's true. Plus the fact is they're never going to change anything because they're making money off it for the increased bills. So,
what is all this junk? 4 kilohertz to 60 hertz. What the heck is all that stuff? Well, why do we have this now? And he and I both have in the past 20 years ago, never saw this. Never. Y'all seen these football-sized fields of solar panels everywhere? What he's told me is that each of these spikes, okay, reflects either the primary or secondary or third-order harmonic of a triac switch inverter in that solar array farm. So they all knew, okay, that the utility company, and if they did this below 3 kilohertz or approximately, that they knew that there would be very little health effect. In my testing and customer
experiences, if the transients that remain are less than 250 microvolts, they seem to do okay 99% of the time.
So these little humps, these are harmonics. This is like, this is 6,000 times a second. That frequency right here is in your wiring, and the wires are Romex. They're not protected, so that radiation comes in about 6 to 12 feet. So even though it's a 60 hertz cycle, 60 up, 60 down, 60 times a second, these frequencies right here are riding what we call above the 60 hertz cycle. But I don't know what frequencies they are. I just know, oh, there's a lot of electricity, right? Back in the day, we plug in these little filters, and we would say, yeah, you have X amount of millivolts of electricity. Okay, now this one here, you can actually hear the noise. So I like that one because you can hear it. It's 155 millivolts, which is actually pretty low compared to most of my houses I go into. And I can tell because the lines here are not very fat. They're pretty narrow. I'm going to leave this on because I have a couple of filters, even though we haven't done all the mitigation yet. But these are some products that we use as building biologists to eliminate that, the stuff that rides above the 60 hertz cycle. So what I'm going to do first is plug in what we call a sine tamer. And a sine tamer actually goes in at the box. Usually this helps more with the smart meters. And I haven't checked outside yet if they have a smart meter yet, but usually it's more of a smart meter, lower voltages. But if it's an LEDs, usually I do better with the what we call the DNA filters. I'm gonna go ahead and plug this in, the bottom down here, and see what happens. Not a whole lot. And this thing didn't go down, but not that much at all. So it's probably did some, but it's not making the noise go down much. So I'm gonna unplug that, put that back up here. Again, this goes in at your breaker box. It also acts as a surge protector. So it has some benefits due to that. Now let's go ahead and plug in this big guy here. This is my DNA filters. And every house is different. Not every house needs a DNA, not every house needs a sine tamer. Plug this in. There we go. Now I felt the shift, and you see how this really has pushed everything back to lower voltages, eliminated the field, and you see the spike in here is gone. So you can do a lot just by doing filters, but as building biologists, we really want to eliminate the source as much as possible. And watch how good job this sine tamer does. So it goes down to 20 here, but look how good it did on the spectrum analyzer, and look how good it did on the oscilloscope here. Now I'm gonna plug this. I've never seen this before, quite this big of a difference. But now I'm gonna show you what the DNA filters will do. These are a little bit more expensive. What I like about the DNA, you take them with you really easy. Now, we're going to plug this in. Now, watch, this goes down below 20. But why these things are not accurate here is because it goes down to 20 when I plug this in, or 11, I mean. So it's actually twice as good, but it doesn't get rid of the 60 kilohertz.
Will you do that again so I can watch?
Yeah, I'm going to unplug it. Okay. Now I'm going to plug it back in. So if you went by this cheaper meter here, you would think, oh, this actually does the best job, but it's not getting rid of the 60 kilohertz or the 80 kilohertz. But I'm gonna plug it in. Look at that. Does a pretty good job overall, but still got those peak frequencies there. And I'll talk to my friend Bill Bathgate about that. Now let's go back to the sine tamer and do it again. So again, on the tri-field here, it went down to 22, which is not quite as good as the DNA, but the frequencies are gone here. And the frequency is what does all the damage, those high frequencies like that. That's 60,000 times a second those frequencies are hitting you. This is 10,000 times a second. Anything above 2,000, the resistance of your skin cannot stop those frequency above 2,000. And I even think that it even goes lower than that, to be quite frank with you. But that's building biology, that's what we're taught.
Yeah, it's amazing. You know, all these wonderful energy efficient devices that we're being convinced to buy and how they make people feel, you know, it's pain and suffering. You know, I went to this house where there was two supposedly non-symptomatic people. I went out into the garage, turned off the Tesla Powerwall storage unit, came back in, and they said, "What did you do?" I said, "Why? The pressure in our head just stopped." Wow. They didn't think they had any problems.
Eric, what is the most common symptoms that you relieve?
Well, for dirty electricity, it's pressure in the head, agitation, anxiety, irritability, suicidal thoughts, urge to urinate frequently, or bed wetting in children, ringing in the ears, a feeling of being electrified. Those are all the symptoms they tell me. Or I'm back in my right mind. I don't feel like killing myself anymore. I've heard that twice.
And do you get those comments immediately, or is it a couple of weeks later that people call, or probably both, right?
Well, sometimes you cut the power and suddenly tears start flowing out of the person's eyes instantly, and or they let out a gasp. And I say, what's going on? And one woman said, it feels like I just got let out of an electric chair. Or one autistic, there's a video on my website where when we turned off the, we unplugged the laptop with a dirty power supply, the autistic daughter, which was sleeping in the back bedroom, came into the living room and said, the pressure in my head is gone. What's going on out here? And then the birds quit flying around, banging into the cage walls. They were just sitting on a perch peacefully. Well, at that point, the unbelieving dad suddenly said, well, okay, Eric, so what do we do to solve this? And I said, well, for one, don't use that laptop anymore. The other day you mentioned that, I think you said you saw the Stetzer units drop from 150 to 50 or 60 by just increasing the grounding rods. Have you found that... there's a basic formula, like 50% reduction?
No, there's so many variables associated with this. The ground soil type, the grounding system, what you've done to change it. You know, that's all. It's all of it. Oh, there's a lot of variables involved here. So I have gone to some where I put one out wire in and it only made 25% improvement in GS units. I've gone to other homes where we did this and we fixed the problem completely. So
wow.
It's there's a lot of variables to this. You're dealing in this in the field where soil conditions and the wiring system and how the customer's panel is wired, all this has an impact.
Bill, if you had a chance to look at the scope, did it clear up more of the high frequency or the low frequency stuff?
It cleared a lot of the lower frequency stuff.
You mean like below 10 kilohertz?
Between 3 and 12.
Oh, okay. So that's the stuff that parallel capacitive filters really don't touch.
Exactly.
Oh.
So that is good news.
Yeah.
Just by increasing the ground or decreasing the ground resistance.
Correct.
Hey, Bill, wasn't there a section yesterday where we talked about not wanting more than one ground rod because the current paths could flip back and forth between them?
That's good. That's why these are only 2 feet apart.
To minimize that.
Absolutely.
Okay.
And you'll notice it's in parallel, not in series.
What is the phenomenon that you're avoiding when you do the right?
You're avoiding this yo-yo effect where this resistance at any moment in time is different than this resistance at any moment in time. And so by the way this is wired, right, in series, the current flow is going to go to this rod for a moment, and then it's going to this rod for a moment, and then this rod for a moment, and this rod for a moment, and keep going back and forth and back and forth.
But thank you. What I meant was, what is the phenomenon in the house for the EHS person that happens as a result of that? What are they experiencing?
They experience a feeling of high pressure. It's commonly what I find. And when I fix coming to somebody's house with this kind of technique, they feel a lot of pressure and they have a lot of stress. And they don't feel normal. They feel much better going outside the house than inside the house.
All right. Thank you. And what is the phenomenon going on in the house that causes the feeling of pressure?
The ground system is now become the path, okay, for dirty electricity frequencies to be, so to speak, sunk. They call it sinking the RF, okay, to a non-conductive surface.
So are you saying that this is due to the devices that they have running in the house?
Or more likely the neighbors and the grid itself. So, lots of stuff going on. As you saw yesterday in our little demo, you know, who would have thought the ground wire had frequencies on it?
Well, if you have a Fluke 289, you can see those frequencies.
But most people, most of us building biologists, have no idea there's frequencies on the ground.
Right. So, Bill, just to put this to bed on the mechanics, you're not going to put two. You're going to put three.
Yes. Rods. I always work in odd numbers.
Okay.
So if I don't get enough resistance here, then I'll do make a circle here, another rod here, another rod here. Then I'll string these together.
Okay. Well, Bill, I have one question.
And I have done some of these triangles. I don't find a difference tremendously with three rods versus the triangle. But when I can't get enough resistance with a triangle, what do?
Start putting wings on it.
Yeah, that's the problem. So you are dealing in unknown territory when you're at a customer's home and you don't know the dirt that well, you know, and you're not living there. So, you know, you're visiting, right? So if you go do this and you got still wind up with like, you know, more than 20 ohms, you're screwed. You just dug all these or driven all these ground rods and didn't get the result you wanted. I guarantee you do this technique, you will get to the end result you're looking for.